second chapter, we'll be taking a look into the fluid tanks, and we'll be simulating this submarine into the tank. So in the previous chapter, as you have seen, we have animated the fans of the submarine. It is looking good. So we have this submarine. So now let's go to the ocean tab here, and here you can see a lot of things. So we have basically four types of tank: so wave tank, beach flat, and ocean flat tank. So for this simulation, we'll be taking a flat tank. So just control, press control and click flat tank, and come to the viewport and just press enter. So now this will be in the middle, in the center, it will come automatically. So we have got four things here. So let's take a look. So basically these two are for caching and rendering part. So here, as you can go inside this, so you can see we have a compressed cache, surface cache, a lot of things. So we'll take a look later. And this is for the fluid interior. So these two are the basic main things. So here, in the DOP network, this is where all the stuff will be going on. We'll be simulating the submarine and everything. And here we can control the size of the tank and all other stuffs. So let's take a look. As you can see, the wave tank is much smaller. So let's increase the size. So just go here. So there is a size. So let's see. So let's keep it somewhere around 70. And this, let's keep it to 100. Is nice. And we have got a flat tank, and we have to increase the size of the bounding box. So let's make it somewhere 50 and somewhere 25. Okay, so let's bring it a little down. So let's keep somewhere 55. So, and let's bring this to somewhere 22. Now we can get this 25 also. Yeah. So now this is nice. So we have a full room of, else we can decrease this to somewhere 40 also. But let's keep it to 55 for now. Okay. So this is the water level. So right now, let's just switch off this. It's taking, so this is the water level. So if I increase 5, so the water level rises. So let's keep it to 0 now. And then we have jitter scale and all these things. So now let's dive into the DOP network. So what we have got here. So here we have this tank, and so these are the two main things which we'll be working on. And then we have a gravity. So in the flat tank, this is the particle separation. So this is the resolution basically. So the lower the value, the more number of particles in the tank. So let's give it a value for now. Let's give it to 0.3. As I don't want much particles for the initial stage. And this is the particle radius scale. So the more the scale, so the more the particles into the tank. And then we have these closed boundaries. So leave it like this. Then we have this initial data. So this is for the visualization. Like you can see, the visualization is in particles. So if you want, you can have grains, rotate time. So basically the grain is very, this is very heavy, so we won't take. So just, so we'll keep the visualization to particles only. Basically this is for visualization of the particles. So we have spheres, sprites, a lot of things, and this here we can visualize the surface, collision velocity, pressure, viscosity, density, a lot of things. And this is the flip solver. So here in the flip tank you can see in the initial data we have the input type to the narrow band, and if I go to the flip solver, so we have a tab narrow band over here. So if I increase the bandwidth, say 5, so you can see the bandwidth increases. So basically this is the bandwidth, and so if the more particles you will get. So for high speed simulations or something, so we have to increase the bandwidth. So for now we'll keep it at 3. And we have volume motion, narrow band, a lot of things. So now we have brought the flip tank and we have set up the flip tank according to the submarine. So you can see the submarine is down the water, and then it will come up, and then it will come up like this, and then it will, there will be splashes and a lot of things. So in the next chapter we'll be starting simulating the submarine. So guys, thank you. See you in the next chapter.